The basics of kidney include what function it does. Of course, we all know kidneys produce urine, so they help in maintaining the fluid balance, water balance in the body. But kidney also has other work in the body. Main is the production of erythropoietin, which helps us to form the hemoglobin in the bone marrow, which is the factory of blood in the body. The next part is bone health. Calcium, phosphorus, uric acid, parathyroid hormone, all these are interconnected with the kidney. That is why bone health is so important in kidney patients. Also, the kidney helps us to maintain the acid-base balance in the body, and this maintains the homeostasis metabolism of the body to a perfect level. So coming to the structure anatomy of the kidney, the kidneys are bean-shaped and they are around 10 cm in length, 6 cm in breadth and 4 cm in width. The kidneys drain into the ureter, which is the urine pipe coming from the kidney down into the urinary bladder. The urine is stored in the urinary bladder and comes out through the urethra in the male and in the female. Coming to the microscopic structure of the kidney is having the outer cortex and the inner medulla. The outer cortex is the one which has the filters of the kidney called as the glomeruli. The blood is filtered in the glomeruli and then it goes down as an ultrafiltrate into the medulla, and there it is concentrated to form the final urine. This then comes out through the chalices and into the pelvis of the kidney and down through the ureter into the urinary bladder. The blood supply of the kidney is by the renal arteries and it goes back through the renal veins. The urinary bladder capacity is usually around 500 ml to around 1.5 liters depending on the need of the person. And the kidneys function around 120 ml per minute per 1.73 meter square of creatinine clearance, but finally per minute around 1 ml of urine is formed. There are 1440 minutes in the entire 24 hours of the day and night, and this 1 ml per minute comes to around 1.5 liters of urine produced by every individual, male or female, in 24 hours. But we do also have social drinking of tea, water, milk, etc. And that is why usually a person has around 2.5 liters of urine every day. We pass urine around 6 to 7 times every day. In the night, usually we do not pass urine. One passing of urine in the night is okay for a person, but if it is many times frequently and disturbs the sleep, it is called as nocturia. How kidneys regulate blood pressure? The blood pressure is related to the volume of the body and the salt content of the body. The fluid volume of the body is connected to the urine volume. So whenever there is a hypervolemia, that there is a fluid accumulation in the body, then the blood pressure would increase. If there is a salt excessive intake, that also leads to increase in the blood pressure. Now, the kidneys excrete both water and salt as its daily function regularly. So that is why if the kidneys are functioning well, then blood pressure would not rise to a high extent. But whenever there is an increase in the fluid volume or there is an increase in the salt intake, then the kidneys are unable to clear it fully and the blood pressure may rise. The kidney hypertension is a connected place, and that is why if the blood pressure is high, you give diuretics to the patient, which are the urine excreting drugs, and this helps to bring down the blood pressure of the person. Of course, diet restriction of salt is required for controlling the blood pressure, but kidneys do help in reducing the blood pressure as such. The renin-angiotensin system, which is acting through the juxtaglomerular apparatus of the glomerulus, is a very important aspect of BP control. So whenever we give ACE inhibitors and ARB type of medicines for controlling the blood pressure, they act on the kidney structures and help to bring down the blood pressure of an individual. Common kidney diseases. Whenever a person is having a kidney disease, there would be albuminuria, that is albumin in the urine, and later on a rise in the creatinine, that is kidney affection. So the rise in proteinuria is usually called as nephrotic syndrome, and that happens in children, adults and old age also. This may require a kidney biopsy, that is a needle test of the kidney, to help us diagnose what is the exact type of problem on the filters of the kidney, the glomeruli. And then special medicines, immunosuppressive medicines, may be given for controlling the disease and for a cure. In patients who are having a rise in the creatinine, if it is a temporary rise of creatinine, it is called as acute kidney injury. And if you correct the cause of it, that would be hypotension, septicemia, infection, blood loss, etc., then the acute kidney injury may recover fully 100%, which may be possible. If the patient is having a chronic kidney disease, which is a long-term affection of the kidney due to diabetes, hypertension, kidney stone, painkiller abuse, then the kidney creatinine may not go back and it may continue to rise slowly as the time progresses. and later on the person may go on to dialysis and kidney transplantation. That is why differentiation of acute kidney injury and chronic kidney disease usually requires clinical acumen of the nephrologist and a sonography report, which tells us about the size of the kidney so that the kidney is recoverable or not can be found out. Causes of kidney disease are myriad and are interconnected also, and they are having a widespread dimensions also. The causes of kidney disease are acute kidney injury and chronic kidney disease. Acute kidney injury is commonly due to septicemia, infections, hypotension, hypertension, painkiller abuse and other medicines which may be harmful to the kidney. While chronic kidney disease is usually due to diabetes, hypertension, kidney stone and sometimes due to unknown factors. In the dialysis department, if you enter, around 60% of patients are due to diabetes, while around 30% are due to hypertension. Few are due to kidney stone, and around 10% of the patients on dialysis are due to unknown causes. You find a person who is having a very high creatinine and start them on dialysis, but you do all the tests including sonography, special tests, etc. But you never come to know what is the cause, and the kidneys are very much shrunken and unable to recover. Signs of kidney problem. Sometimes there may be no signs at all that you are having a kidney problem. But the commonest signs are swelling of the feet, edema feet, that is due to fluid retention. Later on, the person may have nausea, vomiting, anorexia, that is inability to eat. Some of the patients may have very high blood pressure as a part of the kidney problem. Few of the patients may later on have convulsions of the brain when the creatinine is very high. Breathlessness may also happen because of pulmonary edema, that is fluid in the lungs, and severe metabolic acidosis in the blood. This is all cured by treating the kidney disease as such and is helped by kidney dialysis, in which the blood is cleaned, whether the kidney is repairable or not repairable. Preventive aspects of kidney disease. Can you prevent kidney disease? Maybe yes, maybe no. A person with kidney disease, which is of a chronic nature, permanent nature, is usually because of diabetes, hypertension, kidney stone, painkiller abuse, etc. So if you control these diseases, then the effect on the kidney is reduced and the person may not have a progressive disease. But if there is a uncontrolled diabetes, uncontrolled hypertension, then the kidney disease will progress slowly and the creatinine will continue to rise even if you are giving supportive care. In such patients, supportive medicines, nutritional supplements are given by nephrologists, including alpha keto analogs, which help to slow down the decline in the kidney function. When should I meet a nephrologist? Well, usually whenever you do a health checkup, which can be a routine health checkup after the age of 40, then you may find that you have some minor problems in the urine protein or in the serum creatinine, your diabetes is uncontrolled or your BP is very high. Then you need to meet a nephrologist for supportive care and whether it can be reversed. But then if you are having swelling of the feet, breathlessness, nausea, vomiting, then you should go for urine routine and serum creatinine test as the basic tests. And if there is any problem in that, then you should meet a nephrologist as soon as possible. My final thought is that kidney disease is a silent disease. It is not something which even I would know that I have a kidney disease inside. That is why a routine health checkup once a year after the age of 40, or if you are a diabetic, once a year checkup for all the parameters is very necessary and should be done. Thank you.